what's up? We in Clinton Hills. Let's see, this is Decal. And we're going to be speaking about tonight is hip-hop architecture. A lot of people ask, what is hip-hop architecture? What does it look like? What does it mean? Well, in upcoming episodes, I'm going to be breaking down what hip-hop architecture looks like and why is it needed. But hip-hop architecture is a moment sort of in African-American expression where it's an expression of an evolution of a culture, not necessarily an anti-establishment. I like to use the term re-establishment because it's not a reaction. Like I said, it's an evolution of a particular culture. Now, in retrospect, or remember the Harlem Renaissance. There were painters, there were musicians, there were dancers, there were intellectuals, and there were activists. But when I really think about it, that term came about in retrospect, but there was a couple of other expressions that were missing. And architecture and industrial design was missing from that expression. Now just imagine, what if in Harlem, during that Renaissance or where that synergy was taking place, what if that culture expressed itself in architecture and expressed itself in interior design and industrial design? And that's the problem. That's sort of the future. That's what we have to realize now with hip-hop. Now, hip-hop has been evolving. Hip-hop just didn't show up on the scene when Kool Herc was in the Bronx in the PJs, even though that was probably the first time where everything came together, but there was multiple branches, there were multiple roots, you know? And at that moment in time, that's when hip-hop just jumped off and there was an explosion around the city. Bronx popping off in the Bronx, hit Brooklyn, hit Queens, Manhattan, you know what I'm saying? But now hip-hop is close to 30 years old. And what's the next step? The next step is for us to industrialize. See, this is the thing, there's a problem. Hip-hop probably brings in close to multiples of billions of dollars. But who's profiting? Who's profiting from hip-hop? Where does the majority of the profit go to? That's the problem. So, with this expression of hip-hop architecture, the thing is, how do we throw away that paradigm and bring forth a new paradigm? How do we profit from it? In hip-hop architecture, there's three most important principles. One is the fabrication and the construction of the actual hip-hop architectural piece. Umbrella term being Sasa. We use the term Sasa because Sasa is an umbrella term and it encompasses architecture as well as industrial as well as interior design, the term Sasa. But hip-hop architecture cannot be realized unless more than 50% of your workforce is actually from the community, is actually minority, or is actually African American. Because if you ask yourself, okay, there's a paradigm that takes place. Someone comes up with an idea and they rush to corporate America to exploit it. And what I'm saying is that with this hip hop architecture to be realized, we cannot use that anymore.
Why do you feel there's a need for celebrate such a movement?
Well, hip hop architecture is a celebration because this is a unique moment in our history where a particular movement, a particular artistic or intellectual expression has come about void of a reaction or violent aggression. And I think that's beautiful because it's a conscious, it's purely premeditated. Hip-hop architecture, or expressing hip-hop via architecture, really came about, it was a yearning, because people who grew up in hip-hop, grew up on hip-hop, went to college, studied architecture, studied industrial design, And so I think that's a unique episode in our history where we're creating something and it's not necessarily a reaction of being oppressed. There's no aggression coming out, I think, and it's pure in that sense. And it can be used as a tool. Hip hop architecture could be used as a defense mechanism. But the impetus, the incubation stage of it, void of any type of aggression, and I think that's beautiful. I think that's a celebration.
So are you saying oppression no longer exists?
Oppression, definitely. There's still forms of oppression. But when I'm speaking about hip hop architecture being a beautiful celebration, is that this one moment, this one instance in our artistic or our cultural capital where the emergence of a new expression comes about, not because we're fighting against something or we're fighting oppression or it's anti-establishment, but this is a re-establishment and an evolution of our culture. So I think that within itself is a celebration.
Tired of riots, shit is quiet. Simple-minded fools infiltrate rhymy crews. Overcrowded cribs, uncles home from bids, sisters pregnant, fathers on drugs, moms are smoking, beds is piss infested. Make it lava.
Strong, man.
Make it lava.
Strong, man. Make it lava. Strong, man.